Hello, Renaz here, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. And I have oily skin. Well, anyway, today I'll be showing you a new set of ships. A large ship and four small ships that it can carry. Which are back there. We're currently in the cockpit. Alright, how about we get started? Here in front of us is the main ship, known as Great Dane. I went for dog breed names. Don't ask why, I just did. It's pretty much it so far. It has two of those sort of guns on the sides, which are, they're not Gatling turrets, they're actually from a mod pack. The same mod pack as these giant cannons, which fire missiles. Which is kind of weird. Right, over here, we have pretty much the back end of the ship, with thrusters helping it move in various directions. I'd say I go for an interesting design. Although, as a whole, this ship didn't turn out exactly as I wanted it. And it's a connector so you can get oxygen ammo into it. Yeah, this didn't turn out as I wanted it because I had an idea for a design. Like, I had two wings connected pretty much the top of it, which had all the thrusters for forwards and backwards. It didn't quite turn out like that. Think of the Halo Pelican. That's pretty much the sort of design I was going for. Didn't quite work. And near the back, we have two doors to get into it. I'm currently using spectator mode, that's why I could just walk right through. And this is pretty much the room. Instead of having an airlock system, due to it being a bit too small, there's just a button on each side and one in the middle to depressurize this air vent in front. It also has two of the 6-port tiny fusion reactors. Because, yet again, it was too small to have the normal fusion reactor, and these two provide more than enough power. So why take up so much space? And it also saves on a lot of resources. Through here, on a door on each side, we get to the hangar, which has a lot of gyroscopes. And pretty much they're all held. There's currently three variants of these ships. I'm not being inside the conveyor system. And there's the others are on this side. Buttons to control all of them are right over here. These control the left side. First one opens the hatch, that unlocks it from its landing pad. And that also opens and that unlocks it. And it's pretty much the same sort of style over there. That's what opens up. And then they just drop and zoom out. Which, I do have a clip of all the ships, well, three of them at least, flying out, which we'll go to right now.
When are you going to need to detach us?
Now launch. Next from the hangar, we have the lobby area. Pretty much where the pilots for the four attack ships sit. Not really much to show here, apart from there's just seats. Maybe I should put something in so they can control them. Never mind. And at the front, we have the main cockpit. Which is... And that's pretty much it for Great Dane. I think it's a pretty cool design. And I use half slabs here, which are added by a mod. Which, as always, all mods will be linked in the description below. And now, how about we move on to... these attack ships. And while I get these attack ships out of Great Dane, I will show you a clip of me and a few friends using these ships to take down a cryo ship. Everyone engage cryo ship. Use whatever weapons you can. It will fire back.
This should be interesting.
Indeed.
Special concern.
What's the range on these guns?
About 800 meters.
The bigger one, your bigger guns have a further range. The green lasers will tell you when it's aiming at you.
Oh yeah, look at that.
I
Oh crap, I think part of my engine's on fire.
That happens. Fortunately.
Oh, I've got damaged engines.
Luckily, you've got plenty of engines, well, lots of engines in order to do this with. Okay, one of its turrets are down, I think. Shit.
Good luck, guys, I'm gonna go. Yeah.
The top ones are gone. Oh my, someone just disconnected.
That was Timpy.
Ah.
I'm in for the engines.
Oh, I'm down.
Well,
I've
both
lost a lot of weapons.
That's no good.
Whoever's shooting from the distance is missing horribly.
Took one of its turrets out of it.
You need to lead your shots.
Yep, took its turret down.
Well, it's defenseless now.
And here they all are. This time actually as my character. We have Rottweiler, two Dobermans, and a Bulldog. The configuration of the squad in each of these ships, well, the large ships, can be whatever you want. You can either have four Rottweilers, or four Doberman, or four Bulldogs, or pretty much whatever configuration you think will be best. Because you can carry four of any of these. And since all of these ships have identical designs, they'll all fit quite nicely. Well, they obviously do. Anyway, in that clip, I was piloting Bulldog, the one that has these Gatling turrets, as well as large cannons. Wait, why is the dots in there? Weird. Well, anyway, that's pretty much it. The two Gatling guns on front are a standard weapon for all three models. The others have varying sub-weapons. Like for Doberman, it possesses an extra two of the standard Gatling guns, as well as four of these ones. They all have two 23mm guns. Yeah. And this one has four 50mm, which fires like that. Quite noisy things, especially when it's firing all those off. Both Dobermans are identical, and as for Rottweiler, its secondary weapon isn't actually from the same mod pack as all the other weapons. But you don't have to worry about downloading a new mod pack just for these, considering these are vanilla weapons. Reloadable rocket launchers. Just launch off a whole volley of death. Yeah, it's quite dangerous. And, as with all of these ships, you may have noticed in their previous clip, they are all quite agile. And we'll move on to a clip of the Great Dane's agility. Not as impressive as the small ships, but as you can see, it can move around pretty well. Although it does take some time to speed up. That's probably because of its large size and being around, I don't know, about 5.8 million in kilograms. Quite a heavy bugger. And that's about it. All of these ships will be available on the Steam Workshop. Obviously these won't come with that, but you know what I mean. There'll only be three of these ones available, obviously, because two of them are duplicates. Now, before I forget, the containers for this ship are, well, pretty much right in the hangar, as you can see right here. Yeah, I'm currently using spectator mode to be inside the blocks. Has two medium containers in order to store all the ammo it will need, as well as fuel for the fusion reactors. Yeah. And that's it. Anyway, I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.